And now we're back. And now it seems to be working. Well, I think I have lost that game though.
All right, welcome back.
Weird.
There's no opponent like you.
Okay, now everything's set up again. And the game's over. Let's see what I can still leverage. Ooh, I've built up a massive wave there.
Yeah, I already have some minions on the map. Bye bye, repeater. Alright.
Yeah, well.
Problem is, there are a lot of saw blades coming. And I cannot defend against the saw blades. Let's see how it works out.
But I don't think it's. I don't know. It's not really dangerous for you in terms of losing the game.
Because they come through.
What will be happening on my side in about 20 seconds?
Alright.
How the fuck is my repeater already able to shoot across two tiles? I haven't been playing for ages.
Yeah, it's the range modification. Yep. Good game.
GG.
I'm sorry.
No worries, it's fine.
No chance.
Display bugs in Firefox.
I actually won a match against Mario.
Yes, you did. The second in a row. Okay, but I guess we'll have to do that again.
Yeah.
Because that was the proper game with a
the thing
weird
is,
bug splat.
Actually, I'm the current offline champion of Coregrounds.
Offline champion? How do you mean that?
Yeah. The last LAN event at Covadis.
Yeah.
The LAN finals. Of Coregrounds.
We're in your favor.
The LAN death finals. Yeah, I won them.
We had a winner. Thing is, though, I would have liked to see that game online, if only the match history were available. I would have liked to see. That was pretty sad sometimes last week. I would have liked to see the stats after certain games, especially some long ones.
Your microphone is lagging somehow right now.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, I think my internet is weirding out too.
Oh, Mario.
I don't
You're
know
prepared
what...
for streaming. I see.
I don't know. I did nothing. Things just don't seem to be working as usual. Maybe it's time for a new computer.
Nope. It's all because of the stormy weather or something.
Yeah, probably. Interferences. Alright, shall we try again?
Yeah, we probably should play another match.
Yeah, before.
All right, so officially, we'll start the stream here.
Yes, yes.
And no lags, no weird display errors.
Let's
Everything
hope.
Will go fine.
I definitely hope so. All right, I've got a code. XKSK.
XKSK.
Yeah, about the font. I sort of know what you mean, Knappe, but I don't think so. Actually, for me, it's different. I love the new font.
Do you actually look at your shed or my shed? Because I don't see any... I wonder.
I'm looking at both, actually.
Oh, okay.
What to ban? What to ban?
All right, cool. So you banned the repeater. So not see the repeater this game. You know what I just noticed?
What?
I don't have the transceiver.
Unlocked?
Why not?
Well, that is weird. You should have, because it's your invention.
My invention. Oh well.
What exactly do you mean by explosion timer stun? Please elaborate. By the way, Simon, I'm looking at your chat.
Yeah, I'm seeing that now.
Okay.
The explosion timer, the stun is useless. I think the stun is pretty strong at the moment still.
It's still after the nerf, yeah.
No.
Yeah, but it shouldn't be so hard to get there.
I have to ban another thing. I wonder. Okay, I will ban the Iron Strike this time. So, I banned the Mothership because it just has too much HP. And then I banned the Iron Strike because it can be really annoying, especially in combination with stun, for example.
I'll ban the adrenaline because that is, I'd say explode and adrenaline are your strongest abilities. You used those two the best, I'd say.
Yeah, Knappe especially. So Knappe was asking in chat about like the length of stun, and I think especially for towers the length for the stun is really strong because you can combine it with other abilities or with your attack, and I think the strongest property of stun is that it interrupts the movement, so in some situations you just cannot move away. Okay, so you picked the phaser. The phaser is a mid-range tower. It's pretty strong in the early game, but in my opinion, it kind of gets weak if you do not upgrade the health, and that can be a problem.
Yeah, but it's interesting that if you upgrade the health, because the phaser's role should actually be an early game bully, which, I don't know, gets somewhat less useful in the late game. But it's exactly like Simon said, if you do upgrade the health, it still is a force to be reckoned with in the late game.
Yeah. I mean, I think at the moment it gets strong if you farm in the early game. If you gain a lot of XP in the early game with the phaser, it will be a strong unit like mid to late game as well. Alright, what I will do is kind of play a mixture of short and long range units. So I picked the Hammerhead, it's a short range unit but makes a lot of damage. And also I picked the Stinger, which is a kind of mid tier minion that has long range.
Yeah, it's an interesting combination. Strong short range, strong big range. I definitely will pick the Lightning, if only because I want to play it, and I was kind of mad I couldn't in the last game. In terms of minions, I'll still annoy you with the Sawblade.
Alright. Okay. Since now you picked the Sawblades, I will have to pick something to farm. But this time, I will not pick the Boom Blaster, but do something different. I will do something entirely different, and that is... Okay, first I will pick the Shield Generator to guard my Stingers. We already saw it in the last game, the Shield Generators are just giving like the surrounding units, mostly minions, armor bonus.
Yep.
And because of that armor bonus, you can kind of have your minions survive longer, which is good against the Lightning. Now, already said I will not pick the Boom Blaster. I will do something different. I will pick the Sniper. And the tactic will be to have the Sniper farm the Sawblades and then have it really strong
in the late game. Yeah, it's probably not a bad idea. I will go for two ranged minions to accompany my build, because I would rather pick something like the Lasoid or the Kite over a Hammerling in this game, because if a Hammerling hits something that's shielded by the Shield Generator, half of its damage, yeah, doesn't matter. And I want to have more minions with more shots, to single shots being blocked, so they don't matter as much.
Now you explained why you picked that during my pick phase. I wanted to pick the healer, but now that you have so many minions, I will pick the Boom Blaster. Just because I have to kind of control the minion line. And then I have to think. Yeah, we already know Explode is a kind of funky pick now, so I will pick that.
Funky pick.
Now, just for Knappe, Explode will change, but not yet.
Yeah. And by the way, we also talked about nerfing the range on the stunner minions even a bit further. They're still very strong even after the nerf. That will help, and that will probably do.
Alright. Again, these are two solid picks.
The shield was... The stun is just a general good pick. I love this ability. It's so useful in so many different situations. And the shield is perfect to block those big damage heavy shots from artillery and from sniper and hammerhead. Artillery, always.
You always confuse them, it's yeah. funny. Okay, I'll pick Frenzy here, just as a counter pick. Because I don't want your minions, and also I don't want your lightning, and also I don't want your phaser to go nuts with Frenzy. So I have to counter pick. And then, I'm not sure. I think I'll go conservative and
pick the heal.
Pick the heal. I think hurry could be really useful to have to kind of to have more power in my movement, but heal is probably a better pick.
You have hurry unlocked?
Yes.
I don't? Interesting.
Yeah. Mass production would be a good pick as well. But yeah. I think this I have to decide this game with tower fights. That's why I picked heal. Okay,
yeah.
Now let's get in the game.
Alright, good luck, have fun. Finally, a game.
Finally a game. I'll start in the top right corner. Oh, the clicks are fast. The clicks are rapidly rising.
The clicks are real.
The clicks are real. Oh my god. See, I missed a wall build. Lost 2 seconds there.
I already lost.
That lost me the game.
Many seconds already. But I think I'm fine. I'm fine for now. Yay!
Alright, let's see what's happening here. Oh my. Oh. I'm not prepared for this. Let me in through. Okay. Alright, see, I'm not following my game plan. That's not good. I just did one upgrade too much on my sniper. But.
I lost a few minions there. I don't care. I got the lightning.
Alright. Ah, come on, I need to get my sniper in position somehow. Bam! Please, another shot!
And he looks like he is in position.
Alright, let's see. Oh wow, one shot of the sniper is not enough. That's interesting.
They're already upgraded. Alright, they don't really upgrade health, so it doesn't actually matter, but...
Alright, let's see... Come on! I hate this, seriously.
What do you hate?
I had the build sound, and I was just not... granted to... Let me roll.
All right then. I let you in the roll. Ew, stupid me. I could have played that more cleverly. Pity.
Alright.
But your wall destruction definitely is real.
I see what you're doing there.
Yeah, especially, I mean, it's a bit unfair because you mentioned it, but I think if you're wanting to go for tower fights, I reckon it makes sense for me to not give you those and stall the game and wait for late. With those kinds of minions that I have, it makes two times the sense.
What I'm doing now is I'm upgrading my towers a little bit, so I'll be prepared for the first tower fight. And at the same time, I'm building walls on my side of the map, so it takes Mario longer to...
Oh, nice explode. Oh, you got so many. I could have reacted with a shield, but I wasn't fast enough.
Alright, good stun there. Kinda...
saving the day.
Yeah, it was a good idea because now my defense is on the other side of the map. Alright, now I will use a heal to just heal my Boom Blast a little bit. And then also, I can...
Now that I used my stun, it's perfectly fine for you to use it. Makes sense.
Alright, and I'm happy with this because...
You're gonna lose your Boom Blaster? come on!
Yeah! That was close.
Last shot though.
That was close.
Yeah.
I thought I could have the Boom Blaster survive, but apparently, nope.
Just a simple nope.
Nope. Alright, and now you get scared. Because my
sniper's scared? Not at all. I'll take your damage, no worries.
The thing is... Come on, stingers!
I should have done it the other way around, though. I should have gone for the... should have banned the phaser and went for the repeater instead, because I was first pick anyway. Not perfectly played.
Damn it. Yeah, your minions are dealing a lot of damage. I'm not happy with that.
Oh, they should be. That's their main objective.
Bam. I might lose this. Why?
At least you're losing your Boom Blaster.
Why? Why? He didn't farm at all. I hate this. Seriously, he didn't farm.
He's just level 3. He doesn't have many levels, but he's upgraded as fuck. He's 5-5-3. And the necessary 2 level 2 he gained from the experience over time.
I don't like this.
This is gonna be gone in a second. Come on. Nice retreat there.
Problem is, I lose too many minions. Okay, I sacrifice my tower just to kill one minion.
Look at that push! Whoa, what's happening? I'm lagging. Wow! Have I won yet?
Yes, you won.
Well played.
Well played.
That was unexpected though. I wouldn't have expected that push to go that well. I think mass production was a major factor in that victory.
Hmm.
Oh, upgrades. Look at that.
What?
Maybe it was the upgrades.
See, I wonder you triggered so many upgrades, and although you I mean, you spawned a lot of minions and also upgraded them a lot. I wonder how that goes so well.
Thanks for the tip, Knapper. Alright. What did you say again? Sorry, I was distracted for a second.
Oh, I said how you kind of could upgrade so much and still have so many minions on the map. It's interesting.
Yeah, I think that was mass production.
And, yeah.
And Boom all Blaster, of those.
Boom Blaster is somehow weak. I wonder why it's so weak.
I think it's HP. It can't stand too long in a certain spot. I think we over nerfed is HP.
Problem was the not the HP but the. Okay, it has 1,125 HP. And probably default regenerate. No, it has regeneration as an upgrade path.
What was the last nerf? I think that wasn't more than just, I don't know.
You're kind of lagging again, so
okay.
I don't know what you said.
Okay, nothing here. I was just saying the last nerf was probably his HP from 1250 to 1125.
Yeah. We'll see, we'll see. We have to do some more test games.
The latest change. Maybe that should be not necessarily reverted, but something in between, maybe.
Was this before? The thing is, we had the problem with... I don't even know our own page. We had the problem with the modification. And I think with the modification... So let's see, changed.
Yeah, that was only recently.
I cannot find it. Okay, all units now get a fixed amount of... Okay, interesting. Cannot find it.
Ah, Knappe. Strawberry overkill.
Yeah. One of our viewers is eating a lot of strawberries.
Yeah, as always. If there are any questions, post them to the chat. We're glad to answer any or tell you anything about the game.
Okay, I cannot find it. So it was probably not in the last patch, but in the patch before.
What's the change? The Boom Blaster change? That was in...
No. The ability change. The modification
change.
Okay. Your armor modification. Huh.
Yeah, that was in the visual update, actually.
It was in the visual update.
Yeah.
Funny. Okay, so this change was after the Boom Blaster change.
Yeah.
Okay, that might be a problem.
Yeah, might have affected it too much.
because I remember with the modification, health modification, all the towers were kind of stronger. But now that the health or regeneration modification is changed, all the towers are weaker and has an impact for the Boom Blaster. So maybe you have to make a note.
I had again, I had technical difficulties. I didn't get the last, I don't know, 10 seconds because my
You cannot multitask. Why?
No, I can't multitask. The thing is, my microphone went off for about 5 seconds.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I said maybe I have to make a note.
Yeah, I'm at it at the moment, actually.
Okay.
Duly noted.
Cool.
Yeah, well, is Knappe joining us for a match, or shall we play another one? We don't have many questions so far, so shall we head onto the core grounds yet once more? Knappe is probably still close to puking because of the strawberry overkill. All right, shall we do another one? Oh, actually, no, I have 2,500 coins. I can unlock shit.
You can unlock shit.
Oh,
nice.
I have to.
I wish I had so many coins, but I only have. Oh, maybe I can unlock a color. I'm not sure about the color. Maybe an emote.
I already have a favorite. Maybe it's going to
Mario.
Be a sniper.
Mario, still, there is no sorry or excuse me emote. I need one.
Yeah, there isn't. I know. It's
Why
on
not?
The list. It's on the list.
It's on the list.
Soon, TM.
I demand for the next patch, just for Simon, an emote that says sorry.
Right. Let's do it.
Alright. Maybe that would be the perfect transition to talk about the next patch.
Yeah, maybe it would. Yet. Yeah.
Let's unlock something first. So
let's unlock something, play another match, and then we'll talk about the next patch. Patch? Ah, nice. Everything rhymes.
So you don't have the stinger, you don't have the stunner,
yep.
You don't have the tank bomb.
The thing is, I have a current favorite. I think I want to unlock the sniper because I think that is one unit that sort of fits my playstyle. The heal ability would be awesome too. I have many abilities unlocked, obviously. Wall swap would be nice. I like that one a lot too. So I think it's between wall swap and sniper.
Not demolish? What about demolish?
I don't have that too. Wait.
Wait.
That is weird. Okay. This is so weird. Not being used to having all units available. Being used to that and not having them afterwards. That's weird. Still.
Actually, I don't have demolish as well, so that's maybe something.
I think sniper would be the sniper, not the artillery. Sniper would be the safest bet for me. Yeah, on the wall.
Bow.
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 Yes. All right. that one's free today, anyway. Though, is it? No, I couldn't get it. Oh, Knappe would be up for a game. Yeah. If so, who do you want to fight you?
Who do you want to fight you?
Yeah.
That's a weird sentence.
Yeah, my grammar might be a bit fucked up. The last days were pretty mentally draining, but I'll tell you more about that once we have that match after us. And we start to talk about the patch that's coming.
Yep.
All right, what should we do? Simon, me?
Actually, I would like to spectate, and then can I? All right. I can chill.
You can chill and tell you.
Also, I can commentate the game.
All right, exactly. You can cast us. I'll just head into the casual queue, Knappe, and you could just go join me whenever you're ready.
Do you actually get matched versus the AI or not?
No, that doesn't happen any longer since we got that button.
Right,
which
cool.
is so weird. The button's so weird. Ah, in the new version, it's gonna be.
He actually posted a code, so he might can.
Ah, okay. All right, I'll send that game. All right, private join.
I'm so excited to see Kappa play.
The color though. Ah, I should have swapped the color first. I wasn't expecting blue now. Pity,
blue. This is blue. All right, let's see.
Can I change the color and reconnect to a game? Does that work?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Probably not. That's something we could try though.
It might works after the pig phase. Okay, my music changed. I wonder what this is.
All right. What will I ban? What would I ban? The saw blade is banned. That is a pity.
Wow, you have many colors.
I do. I have to admit. I mean, I'm playing an account that has basically zero cheating regarding the general, I don't know, units, modifications, stuff like that. But cosmetic updates, I have to admit, I have cheated. I have unlocked many colors for myself.
I know. I think it's good if you produce some videos and stuff like that. It's good for the videos. The cool thing is, there are actually some new players playing. That's why I'll spectate there, I think. And we have a match of Gabrielle against the AI.
Ah, you're spectating a match by another player?
Yeah.
Ah, nice.
One thing you can note is that the new font is not loading in the spectator modus.
Yeah, it's we're working on that.
We're working on that.
Soon TM.
Okay, the cool thing is she actually upgrades her units. I don't know if it's Gabrielle, could be a guy as well, right? So the player is actually upgrading the units, which is cool. But the player is not building towers, which is weird. But it seems to be a really easy AI.
So he's okay because, to do so.
And because the player is spawning so many minions, the AI will probably lose. Right, cool. Really good. I'm impressed. And also, there's another game. Slow Mito versus the AI.
Yeah, there's been stuff going on during the last days. There were quite many people online playing stuff.
This seems to be a stronger guy because it is building a lot more walls and also spawning a lot more minions. And the player actually upgraded the towers a little bit, but not the minions yet. Now is upgrading towers while the enemy minions are coming. And the player is also using abilities, which is good. But, player lost a tower. Alright. Looks good. Good gameplay. I'm proud of you, Slomito. I will spectate your game. All right, this looks really funky. The spectator mode is kind of bugged.
Is it maybe... Are some factories not showing in the UI or something? When they're on cooldown? That might be the same thing that happened to me before.
No, it's just the fonts are not loading, and also... Yeah. It all has the old background and... Yeah, the old background and fonts, so...
Okay.
Okay. Okay, Knub is just asking how it works with a 7-wall stack. And it's simply you get a stack of 7 walls in the beginning of the game and you can immediately build them. So what you can do and already ask is use the shortcut and build 7 walls in a row. It's easy, you'll see. Alright. And here we have the picks of Knappe, the repeater, and 4 minions. 4 shooting minions. It's actually quite good because minions seem to be strong against 3 towers and... No, 4 towers and 1 minion on Mario's side. And then we have shield, adrenaline, and mass production against frenzy, iron strike, and heal. I wonder why you picked that, Mario. It does not make any sense.
It doesn't make any sense? Why? How so?
You'll lose this game
so
hard.
I don't think so. I don't think so, man.
You'll lose so hard.
Okay.
I promise.
Way to go.
You'll lose so hard. Alright. Now we see some aggressive wall building by Mario. And moving the towers around.
Senselessly. As usual.
Knappe is a little bit more conservative with his walls. And I'm not telling you what he's doing. You have no chance, Mario. No chance. Mario, I'm not confident that you'll win this game.
We'll see.
Knappe will destroy you.
We'll see, we'll see.
In his hands. He will crush you so hard. Alright. I like that move by Knappe. He's moving forward his repeater, but then he decides to upgrade it again. And I wonder if that was a good decision, because Mario can attack and has a defenseless tower for another 9 seconds. Also uses the frenzy. Another 3 seconds, but Knappe has... Oh! The sniper shot is coming in, but the adrenaline is so strong! And he uses shield. So he had to waste 2 abilities to save his tower. But as we know, adrenaline is pretty strong, so he regenerated already half of his health. But retreating now to destroy that one tank that is lost between the nodes. Alright, and there we see a little stealth action by Mario, trying to move forward with his walls, but first he has to retreat with his phaser, because there's no chance against so many shooting minions and the repeater.
Yeah, it does look kind of bleak right now.
Alright, and now we'll see if these towers are enough to get rid of so many minions. And also, I think he has to spawn more tanks. As many tanks as he can. And he has to make the minion line longer. Alright, now another shield by Knappe, protecting his minions for a couple seconds to deal damage on the lightning, which is kind of doing the most work right now, but has to retreat now because
That was so stupid. Fucked up big time. Oh man.
All right another adrenaline coming in. makes the repeater really strong. But Mario has his healer as well, which is healing his towers really quick. And although although Knappe has adrenaline on his repeater, he has to retreat. Alright, let's see.
And full health again. There you go.
Alright. Problem is, you have to spawn more tanks. Spawn more tanks. Spawn, 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 spawn.
They're upgrading now. I can't.
Cool thing
he had
is,
the, he had the shield ready. I wasn't expecting that.
Cool thing is, the shield just came available 2 seconds ago, so he was able to use it. I like that.
Close right. One. Close one.
So let's take a look at. So the phaser just reached level 3, which is not enough, I think. And the lightning is not leveled as much. I wonder, it's already 4:30 in.
What the fuck is wrong with my internet today?
Just because today's Thursday and they know we're streaming Coregrounds.
I know, yeah. Sabotage! I smell sabotage!
Alright, again, the repeater's coming in and trying to deal damage and get rid of the lightning. But the healer is so strong with the frenzy. But for now, we will retreat. Mario will retreat with the lightning. And the adrenaline actually missed the tower, which is not good.
The same thing happened to me with the heal before, though.
Alright, and now we have the lightning. With
no,
its
we
attack.
Have a minion limit.
Yeah, there are a lot of minions on the map right now, but they're not actually doing that much because the range of the minions is not that high. So mostly only the foremost minions are attacking, and that gives Mario the chance to farm the minions away, which makes his towers really strong. So we'll see how this will play out. Again, in a couple seconds, the repeater will be ready, and then maybe we'll see another attack by Knappe. Ah. The lightning.
The thing is, though, as opposed to. Yeah. You can go and try.
Frenzy is ready already. And I think the shield will not be enough, but gives him the chance to retreat. And.
I need more vision.
Alright. The thing is, the healer is actually doing work for you. And if the lightning is getting strong and stronger, you might be able to kind of farm these minions all the time.
I think so. I think it's not as lost as you immediately.
Whoa! That was a ridiculous shot by the sniper. So much damage already. But it also has 4 damage upgrades, so almost killed the repeater. I'm surprised.
It's pretty quick now, though, the repeater.
I wonder if you should attack that tile. Maybe you should attack another tile.
Oh, why not?
Just because if you place your phaser there and build the wall there, you will be attacked by the minions.
That is right, yeah, you're probably right, but it's too late now anyway.
Yeah.
Alright,
another shield coming in to save the repeater. And your wall will be snacked away. But I will give you a hint! I will give you a hint, Mario! Yes! Perfect play! Perfect play! I like that!
I wouldn't have needed the wing. How many were that? 5? 5 at least.
I loved it. I love that. Alright. And also, you have another heal. And yes. Already deals 50% damage to the core. But it might be not enough.
It's enough for the repeater.
It's enough for the repeater, but now you probably have to retreat. If he shows the other tile, you might have...
Yeah, would have been able to stay, yeah.
Alright, cool thing is that the repeater is out of the game right now, and is currently 20 seconds away from being built again. And you're free to move in with your phaser.
Damn
but
it!
The shield.
Horrible timing there.
Problem is, now that you placed your sniper there, you're not able to move out.
That was actually planned, to be honest. Because I wanted to get the sniper in.
Bam! That's approximately 10% damage on the core.
With every single shot.
With every single shot.
But it's not going to be enough, unfortunately.
You maybe have to build your phaser. And Knapp is reacting fast, which is good. I tell you, the lightning is doing work for you.
Yep. It's basically taking care of a line of four different minions by himself, which is amazing stuff.
Yep.
So let's get some room to move here.
Alright. Now it actually looks good for you, I have to admit.
I don't need that fight.
You're so smart. Alright, and now we have the situation that Mario actually can move in, but the Stingers already have quite a lot of range. So we'll see if that works out. But the cool thing is, now Mario can exchange his towers and just kind of have shots ringing into Knapp's core. And this game might be over soon. But the regeneration is actually...
Come on, yes! Yes!
Yes.
Predicted! But it's still too fast. Amazing stuff.
Actually, the... Oh! Towers are strong. But the repeater actually
GG.
Upgrades movement speed, so...
GG, Knapper.
Good game, actually. Well played, both sides. I see that the healer and lightning combination seems to be quite a valid and quite a good pick.
Especially since all of Knapper's minions had low health. All of them. They're perfect snacks for my lightning.
Perfect snacks.
Yeah. Small little bites. You never bite off more than you can chew.
Alright.
Good game, well played. The spawns though. 150 minions. Yeah, but if you look at the XP, that's almost double. Of what Knapp had.
Can you tell me the match ID?
Yeah. 5790.
Alright. Yeah, a lot of XP gained because so many minions were farmed. A lot of damage dealt. Also a lot of healing.
Yeah. I love that combo of the healer and the healability. If both those projectiles hit at the same time, the towers would go from half health to full in a split second.
It's crazy.
Yeah. All right. Can I spectate one game you guys do before we talk about the patch and the upcoming changes?
Maybe we should talk about the patch now.
Sure. There's a lot to tell. Well, what do we want to begin with? I mean, there's of course the big topic, onboarding.
Maybe we should talk about units first.
Which kind of units we want to do?
Because we're not sure which units we should bring.
That actually is a good point. Yeah.
All right. So I just opened the dev grounds. And I will just scroll through the dev grounds, I think, and see if there are any good ideas posted by our community. Recently, there were some new people committing stuff to the dev grounds, so let's see if
the mole and the charger, for example.
The mole and the charger. All right. So, for example, we have a poison tower. Shoots poison on target. Poison hits for time X with a damage of X in seconds. Ignores armor and shield. This tower would avoid a strategy around permanent shield. Alright. So this is probably something that was posted... Yeah, it was posted 4 months ago when shield was really strong, especially with a shield generator.
Yeah, right off the championships.
And we probably don't have this problem anymore because the shield generator only supports with armor now, not shield in general. Let's see what else there is. We have the mortar. I don't know how to pronounce that. It's the AoE minions which throws bombs in mid-range. The enemy has to be at least... Oh yeah, I like this idea. Actually... I actually would like to see a minion that kind of shoots from longer range in the minion line, but is not too overpowered.
Mm.
Because, for example, we had this scenario now. Knappe just picked four minions, but three of them were kind of low-ranged, at least in the early game, and only the Stinger had long range. And to have another minion available that would kind of shoot on a long range, but it has something that nerfs it, would be cool.
Yeah, I think so.
So I actually like this idea. Okay, it's in my mind now. Let's see.
Definitely one thing we've been talking about for months now is we have the executioner in the game for almost half a year, I think.
Yep.
And it does triple damage to slowed, stunned, and rooted targets, but we still don't have any root effects in the game. So I think an ability that roots people or, I don't know, some kind of tower or minion that has that as a side effect should be one of the new units we add.
All right. So as an ability, we should introduce the root. But what is rooting in detail, Mario?
Rooting means, as opposed to a stun, for example, you can still attack. You just can't move. If you have any movements going on right now, they get cancelled and you can't start new movements. Same for minions that are just fixed to the place they're at the second they get hit by it. But you just have to stand still, but other than that you can fight and do everything you normally could.
So just a worse stun?
Yeah, but with a longer duration.
Oh, a longer duration. And what about the cooldown?
Good question, though. Interesting. Yeah, probably depends. If it's just an ability, the cooldown could be similar to slow.
Yeah, I wonder. The thing is, I think the cooldown should be longer than the cooldown for stun, because at the moment, the strongest property of stun is to cancel movement, in my opinion, and not
to have units at a certain spot. Yeah.
So actually, this is really strong. So I would have a longer cooldown, but the duration of the effect should be longer, maybe like 3.5 seconds or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then it could work. So it's a different, it would be different to stun as well, because you could not use it as often in the game, and you kind of have to decide when to...
Yeah, to get the timing right. And if you get it right, it should be strong.
Yeah.
Mm.
All right. Okay. So root, that should be something. That should be something we should introduce. Cool thing is, it's actually a buff for the execution as well. And I would like to see this tower more often.
Yeah.
More often.
Or maybe more similar towers. That also would be interesting. Maybe.
Wow. So we actually have Gabriel starting another game. And also we have Slomito. But it might be the same game. I'm not sure. Yeah, it's the same game, I think.
Still going on.
Yeah, 22 minutes already. Might be a new game, but the pics are kind of similar. All right, cool. So back to the Dev Grounds. Ah, I wish we could introduce a new Fog of War, but that's something we have to wait for.
Yeah, unfortunately.
I'd love to see it and see how it plays out.
Ah, there's so many things I'm already wishing for, especially things like with the kind of effects and spells we can do on the new server. We can get crazy in terms of units. We can do so much cool stuff so easily. We'll be pumping out units a lot quicker than we currently are.
Alright. Also, there's a decoy. I really like that idea, and I would like to see it in action. I still wonder if it's super weak or super strong. Probably it's a weaker ability. But I imagine so many cool tower fights with
a decoy being placed. I think that is a really cool ability. I think so, for a small cool micro play.
Yeah, but yeah, maybe it's too weak. I wonder, because you have to be really precise, and you can count it really easily by just moving the towers away, essentially.
The thing is, I have another tower on my list. I forgot if it was my or someone else's idea, but I have a tower on the list, the Brute, which is basically the decoy is a temporary unit that has taunt and makes everything attack it. We could also have a tower that does that. Doesn't have an attack, is a tank basically with taunt. A tower that has no attack but still could be very useful, because as opposed to the decoy, you could use the Brute to move in and catch towers.
Yeah, I see what you
would maybe be even more interesting in terms of microplay, but might be too weak too, because I don't know, having one tower less just for that effect is a lot of commitment.
But it could play out pretty funnily. Funnily.
Nicely.
It could play out nicely, especially against minions, because then you could kind of have that tower just tank minion shots and farm minions. I mean, you would have to give it a lot of HP or a lot of regeneration. Maybe you could have it like something 1,200 HP, but ridiculous amount of regeneration.
Mm.
Or maybe just 1,000 HP, a ridiculous amount of regeneration, so it can't be destroyed by minions.
Only by burst itself. Damage.
Only be destroyed in a kind of, as you say, in a burst.
Yeah.
With, for example, a hammer hat or explode or a shotgun or a sniper, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
So in a range where if you kind of have your minions alone, they cannot do anything. But if the minions are coming in with a sniper, with a support, it should tip over and you would have to use an ability or something else.
Teleport it away.
Teleport it away, yeah.
Okay, so I'll write down decoy slash brute. It's 3 already.
A fake tower. An idea by Hamjo. Add in fake tower, which looks like a tower you have, but does nothing.
That's actually pretty similar to the decoy idea. Maybe those two could sort of be merged.
Oh, so the decoy actually looks like one of your towers?
Mm-hmm.
You just don't want to design a decoy.
Maybe.
Alright.
I also like that that idea by Broham a lot. The tower idea spawner. A tower which spawns minions, one of your minions you have available.
Yep.
I think that's a very, very cool idea.
I'm just not sure how that's supposed to work. So the problem I see is the minion. So it would be cool to have that tower kind of being built and then have a split minion path, like minions coming in from two directions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
the
exactly.
The problem is, then you have so two minion paths are actually available. And then at the end of the game, you only can build that tower at the existing minion path. So either you do that, or if you build that tower, kind of walls explode and you get a new minion path randomly generated or something.
Do you see
the problem?
Yeah, I see the problem, but I don't think it has to get that crazy. It is a simple power and you have to abuse it, and if you don't, you're...
Yeah, but the thing is, so for example, you build that tower early, and you create a second minion path. Then you're forced to move your tower away, for example, because of an iron strike. And the second minion path would not be valid anymore.
But it doesn't even have to be a second minion path. Imagine you have just one path and you have a tower fight going on sort of in the middle of the map, and you move that spawner, I don't know, closer, you move that one behind the enemy towers, so it's spawning these minions on the one path, yeah, but closer to the core and after the towers, so they don't get farmed as easily. So I think for this tower, movement would be crucial, or positioning in general. And by positioning it cleverly, you could take advantage of any kind of map situation.
But how would you manage, like, would you just have more minions, or would you kind of, like, what's the pace of the minion spawn? And are the minions the same that are coming out from the core?
They would be randomly picked. I mean, for example, you have 3 minions picked, and this spawner tower. For example, you have the tank, the kite, and the laseroid. And every time the spawner is ready to spawn a minion, it would randomly choose one of these three. So a tank, then a laseroid, then a tank, then a tank, then a laseroid, randomly. And spawn it at a tile next to it, which doesn't have a wall. And that would be it. Pretty simple system, but I think a system that could be abused to a crazy extent with a certain amount of skill. Especially
What I imagine right now,
yeah,
is that you kind of, you have like two lines of walls against each other.
Yeah.
Then you use demolish to destroy one of the enemy walls, and you place a tower there, and it spawns a minion, so the enemy cannot place a wall there anymore because the tower is occupied by a minion.
Yeah.
And then you use the minion limit to have these minions explode and kind of destroy all the walls around.
yeah, exactly.
That would be ridiculous. Okay. But that's like such a gimmicky game plan. I probably wouldn't work out. I wonder.
Also, I think this would especially shine for minions with longer spawn speeds, because
you know another thing, same scenario.
Yeah.
And you demolish a wall, you have your kite spawning there, all on one position, and then it will just shoot rapidly on the core, for example.
Yeah.
That would be crazy. See, but what happens if no free tiles available around?
Then it just doesn't spawn.
It doesn't spawn.
So you have to always keep it at the edge of your wall, your maze.
Yeah, Mario, it's a crazy unit. I wonder if that would work out. I mean, we can build it and test
just
it.
Just try, yeah.
I mean, should not be too difficult to build it.
I think so, exactly.
Even like early game, imagine you have a lot of early game minions,
yeah,
and you build that tower and place it like in the front, and then just minions are jumping out and are super close to the, and then the opponent has to kind of trap these minions so they don't come out.
Yeah. Or on the other hand, imagine for example, if you have something like the mothership that's spawning really slow, and you immediately build that tower without even upgrading it. You build it, and you might get lucky, and it would just spawn a mothership in half the time a mothership usually takes.
That's true.
And yeah, that might just be one mothership, but in the early game, that can mean a lot.
Okay. Now, supposing we would be implementing that, what would the upgrades path be?
So
probably spawn speed.
Spawn speed or attack speed, whatever. So the speed at which the tower spawns minions. Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely. Maybe movement speed. I'm not actually a huge fan of Braham's idea to make the tower give the minions he spawns an extra HP buff. I don't think that's even necessary. I think the turret would be strong enough on its own. I think attack speed, movement speed, and maybe HP to have it quite squishy at the beginning. Squishier than any other tower, so before you can actually venture behind enemy lines with it, you would have to upgrade it first to get it to the late game so it can move as far.
The tower starts with 150 health? How's that supposed to work?
Yeah, I think that's... He thought that...
Okay.
I'm not even sure. But I think that's... All of that's too complicated. We don't need that. Extra buffs and weird...
okay, by the way... Bro HM... If you have... At any point, if you have... Well, if you at any point watch this... I think this is a really cool post to the DevGrounds.
Yeah.
It has everything.
I mean, it has even the description and the difficulty level to it. I mean, this, we don't have to do anything, basically. We
okay, bro, HM.
Nicely played, bro.
Yeah. We'll implement it right away. But my concern is that that we have to make some modifications.
For that? To support it?
No, I mean, we just have to change it. That doesn't work like that.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. Well, there's some code work involved, but yeah, apart from the code, he did everything he could.
Yeah.
Certainly not worst post ever, Knappe. Maybe one or two of your posts might fall into that category, but our one is a fine post. Definitely.
Yeah. So minion health, I think this is not a good idea, especially if you have a minion like the mothership. This can be really overpowered. 50% health of a mothership.
Yeah,
in
which
the late
already
game,
has much health. Yeah.
In the late game, then you have motherships driving around with 1,500 HP or something like that. That's not going to work. So I like the idea of I actually like the idea of movement speed, but I wonder if that is too weak, because... Huh.
Movement speed...
I just wonder how it helps you. You kind of... Like, a mechanic I could see is that you have ridiculously fast movement speed, and you just wait for...
the spawn to be ready and then move to the edge, spawn the minion and move back quickly.
Yeah.
Oh, Knapp is pissed off.
Right.
Oh, right, there was that post. I remember now.
All right,
mate.
Yeah, it's true. It's not perfect yet.
Yeah.
But that's why I have to discuss it, because I like it. It's because it's a new idea, and it's something I have not thought about yet, or I did not consider to be possible. And that's why we're spending time on it, to see if it would be possible.
Yeah.
All right. So attack rate is obvious. Then regeneration. Huh. The thing is, if you would give it regeneration and movement speed, I wonder if these are, in some situations, just useless or not.
Yeah, I don't think that regeneration... I mean, that tower would have to be squishy. It can't have much HP. I think that would be overpowered. That way you could just leave it somewhere and not care about it. I think this one is dangerous and it should be taken care of, it should be taken care of by both players. So it should have low HP, but wiggle room to play. So I think movement speed is kind of that direction, having low HP but high movement speed.
If no minions are chosen, on bullet minions. Yeah, I like that. Oh, this is actually Knappe's comment was deleted.
Yeah, that's what I referred to earlier. That's probably
funny.
why he said that he's leaving now.
Yeah, it's controversial.
Yeah. Yeah, but it's not the first controversial thing we did, and I think in the long run, the game is profiting so much from this diversity in terms of gameplay and mechanics and all that kind of stuff. I mean, if everything's just one kind of tower, one kind of minion, and same kind of playstyle every time, it's not exciting in the long run. Anyway, the changes, man. All right, oh no, we have to. I wrote the spawner down now. So we have four.
I have to think about the spawner. I don't know if there's something cool we can do with the upgrade path.
Yeah. Or maybe
the thing is.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm just concerned that, like, you have to create an incentive. This tower spawn minions in the front line. If you just hold it back and use it to spawn more minions, that would be not so cool, you know?
Yeah.
So maybe it should have something like...
Yeah, but I mean, in the backline, it probably won't do as much. If you let it stay back...
Yeah, but you have
you
to...
just have a bigger minion line, but those minions would be better off probably if you just pick them instead of having a tower do it, probably less effective than the minions itself.
You have to find that sweet spot, you know?
Yeah. In terms of the attack speed the tower has. So
yeah.
It's not faster than the minion itself. Yeah.
And also you cannot make it too weak, so it can do something on the front line, you know?
Maybe if you consider that more, maybe the giving those minions a slight buff maybe isn't the worst idea after all, because it would you could make the attack speed relatively low, let it spawn not as many minions, but if you do spawn them, they have an advantage, you know.
Yeah, but then I would just have it spawn these super minions in the backline, and happy about it, you know?
Yeah, we have to think about that.
Yeah, I wonder if there's another cool upgrade path. I mean, could be possible to just have tank more damage. But that's not cool enough.
Yeah, the poison tower is very interesting too, I think.
Okay, you want to change topic. I see. Sorry.
No, sorry. I was just thinking about the list as a whole, and we can't have all towers and I don't know. I think a good amount of units for the next patch would be 5.
All right.
Another
thing. The third on the list for tower is actually the reflector, and maybe we should give Titim. I'm still not sure how to.
Titim Reaper. Just say
Titim Reaper. some credit here, because actually this idea initiated the creation of the transceiver.
Yeah.
And didn't to have a tower reflect a portion of its incoming damage to its source. But now we have a tower that does even more.
Yeah.
And it's crazy.
That's actually something we should include that there somehow. It's sort of done that way, and he also deserves that one for free probably.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll write that down. We'll do that.
Late credit, but
sort of, yeah.
Yeah, if you haven't played the transceiver yet, it's quite a funky tower. You can try it out. What it does is it kind of absorbs all the damage he takes, but also absorbs all the damage that surround units take. For example, if walls around take damage, he absorbs this damage. And then the transceiver stores the damage. And once he's able to attack again, he kind of blasts out this damage in an area of effect attack.
About the same range as the boom blaster.
Yeah.
And the thing is, this unit can store so much damage. If you leave it in the backline long enough, filling up his damage, he can easily reach about 1,000 damage and one-shot basically anything.
And it's kind of hard to play. It's probably more for the advanced players, but yeah, you should definitely check it out if it's available for free, or if you ballsy enough, you can even unlock it.
That is a ballsy move, though. No, on the other hand, we have refunds, though, so it's you're just wasting a few. Coins.
I mean, there's a good reason why we gave this tower difficulty hard. Ah, secrets. because I think it's kind of hard to play. You have to get the movement of the towers down and the towers, and then you also, it is more assassin tower. It doesn't have that much. I think it has less than 1,000 health. I'm not sure. Let's see.
900.
Yeah, it has only 900 health, though. So it can be destroyed quite quickly. And also, the regeneration is lower than usual. You have to upgrade it. And it only reaches the regeneration level once it has 5 upgrades.
Yeah.
Generation. So. It's hard to play.
It's a unit, though, that I think at one time might use a little buff, because especially given its difficulty in playing it, I think it could be stronger.
No, I think in my opinion
a little more damage.
No, in my opinion, this is a tower that is a top of flop. If you use it right and you have the right situation in the game, this is a top-notch tower and you can do crazy moves with it. But if like the odds are against you and the positioning of your towers is not working out, and I don't know, the picks are kind of weak or whatever, it can be flopped really quickly. The thing is, if you would buff it, like, then like this top-notch plays get too strong, in my opinion. But I mean, we're open for change, and if you have a suggestion, then please tell us.
Yeah, it's rather just, I don't know, a feeling like it could do that top-notch thing a bit better. I mean, even if I played it and even if it worked out, I felt like, yeah, it did a shitload of damage, but it didn't get as many kills as I wished it would, or didn't level as fast. I don't know, that hack speed is pretty low and it's very hard to time those. On top of all the other disadvantages it has, like regeneration, you can't leave it there, but you have to wait 4 seconds before it attacks again, and 4 seconds in Coregrounds time are an eternity. So I think maybe a bit more attack speed, a bit more ignore armor, just I don't know, tiny bit upwards would make it feel more rewarding to play, I guess.
You have no idea how to play this tower, man.
Yeah, but even if it's, I don't know, if it's charged up to 75% or something, and it does 700 damage, it doesn't kill towers. And if it's your only tower left, or if you don't have something else to help at the moment, it can't get kills ever. It can do a lot of damage and help other things, but it's a support tower rather than something that gets kills.
That's why I said it's a funky tower.
Funky in many different respects. Yeah.
I remember, like, in one of the last games, I actually played the transceiver against you, and it was super strong. Like, it destroyed two towers within the first 3 minutes. Something like that. It
was
crazy.
Last week?
Yeah, I think it was 1 or 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
And it was crazy strong.
Okay.
Let's see if I can find that match. The problem is I lost all my matches against you. Probably I lost that match as well, and it was just strong in the beginning.
We'll find that easily. No transceiver game there, though. Maybe on the second page. No, I think that was offline. You haven't played the transceiver against me.
Yeah, maybe that was on a...
That was last week when we were on the local setup.
Oh, yeah, I see. So I cannot actually show it off. That's unfortunate. All right, so back to the Deathgrounds, maybe. We have talked about transceiver enough now, but don't forget Tim the Reaper.
It's noted.
Thanks, Tim. Reflector was a really good idea, and it made it to the game. All right, what else do we have? Wow, this music is crazy. I need different music here. Okay. Hate suggested the minigunner. a heavy tower with very high rate of fire, high damage, but a poor range. The longer it shoots, the faster it is. Extremely strong against weak minions and lots of armor. Sounds super overpowered, Hate. I don't like the idea. Actually, it was downvoted as well. I think towers that are... I wonder how could this could work.
No. I'm not sure, actually. I can't imagine that working. Like a repeater that you have to control more. Or that you can outplay more easily.
But if it has more, like a higher rate of fire than the repeater...
Yeah, not in general, but I don't know, after 5 attacks or something. Like the sunbeam, but it doesn't upgrade its damage with every attack, but the attack speed.
Huh. But that would be strong against every unit.
Yep. Especially... No, not necessarily against minions, because it would have to be the same target. Attacks on the same target would make it faster.
Yeah.
So it maybe would attacks actually be on, better
maybe,
against towers.
Maybe attacks on different targets. That would be crazy.
That would be crazy indeed.
That would be so crazy.
That would be really cool, actually.
You would have to kind of implement a new target selection,
random.
Though. Maybe not. Yeah, I'm not sure. That would be pretty cool, especially because it would make the tower again good against
minions.
Like, multiple towers, you know?
Yeah.
Huh. Okay.
Interesting idea. I like that. Noted.
Noted, but let's move on. I have to kind of think of that a little more.
Yeah. The thing is, we've been talking about units so much, but we should shortly at least touch what we've been actually talking about the last few weeks and
yes.
What our main plan for the next patch is.
Yes, let's do that. I'm excited.
The thing is, during the Games Week, we were showing Coregrounds last week at the Quo Vadis conference and the Amaze festival, and we've had tons of people play the game and looked over a lot of shoulders while they did play the game, and we realized that some parts of the UI definitely need improving. The controls are not intuitive, or at least there's not enough options for all the ways to play the game people just bring to the game that they're not in it. Drag and drop, for example. I've seen a lot of people try to drag towers onto the map, and that obviously didn't work. It's something that's basically pretty easy to implement, and that is just one of many, many examples we want to improve the game. So the UI is very important and is going to be changed a lot in the next patch. And also in preparing for those kinds, we also pitched Coregrounds at the, we were a nominee for the Best of Quo Vadis Award and pitched the game to a nice audience. And yeah, while preparing for that, we realized that at the moment the data, the analytics aren't really speaking for Coregrounds. At the moment, we have a retention rate of only 23% for day one. That means that less than a quarter of everyone that comes into the game actually stays and comes back after the first session they play. And that is something we definitely want to improve. As Coregrounds gets better, the more players it has, this is a very, very, very important thing to improve on. And there's different areas where we realized we had to work on. At the moment, the new AI is awesome, but it's sort of tough to new players, especially because the builds are very effective and the AI is upgrading crazily, and especially new players seem to have some problems with that. So we definitely want to make the AI more adaptive to what skill the player is actually bringing onto the Coregrounds. And also we want to improve the tutorial, and instead of a video tutorial, have an actual in-game tutorial. And that is something we've been working on a lot conceptually for the last 2 weeks.
Talking about adaptive AI, we have a, maybe it's too hard at the moment. So we had a new player coming in today, and the player actually lost the first game, won the second game, and then lost 3 games in a row, but is still playing. I'm happy about that.
I know, it's awesome. I love that, actually. The thing is, I don't love that the game is obviously too hard to new players at the moment. But I love that at least some players, they aren't deteriorated by that, but they really get going. You see them losing 3 games, 5 games, 7 games, maybe even 10 games, and then they sort of flip the switch and just go wreck everything and win every single game. They really want to do it.
So there's another new player today. I actually spectated him shortly today, and he had one game going on for 50 minutes, a hard fight, 3 units up to level 20, and unfortunately the player lost the game, but mostly because he didn't upgrade his units or her units that much. So I think, yeah, we'll work a little bit, or we'll kind of have some more advanced mechanics on the AI, and that will probably help new players especially.
Ah, that is a tough one though. Ah, how mean. 3 units on level 20.
Yeah. But the problem is the upgrades.
I would have loved to see this game. Yeah, probably. Yeah. It's almost half of the upgrades the AI has. Yeah, but that is a perfect example of what we want to do with the AI. I mean, it's very simple. We just say if the AI shouldn't upgrade more than 5 upgrades more than the opponent has. For example, the AI would have stopped here at about 35, 40 upgrades, so Slowmito would have had a chance.
Depending on the skill level as well.
Yeah.
So, it's so easy, we should do it.
Yeah, exactly. And that's just one example. We're definitely gonna do, we're gonna...
Whoa, pretty cool. So I'm spectating another game, and Slowmito actually used the Iron Strike on the minion line. And
at the core?
No, on the minion line.
Okay.
And actually hit like 5 or 6 minions because the AI is actually playing the Saw Blade. It's pretty cool.
That is hard to time that, yeah.
I probably never hit that many minions with the Iron Strike that was not on the core.
Yeah.
Wow, cool.
Oh, those motherships are doing work.
Yep. Oh, you spectate the game as well?
Yeah.
Cool. cool.
It looks weird with the font though.
We have to update the spectate mode as well.
Yeah. Maybe I should quickly touch on that because it's been so fascinating this week. We've been talking about during Games Week last week. We've been talking about a lot about the future Coregrounds has and what we have planned, and obviously having a game that is not working perfectly in all browsers and is only playable in browsers isn't what we're effectively want to do. Effectively, we want to have a game that is available on Steam and on iOS and Android and all that, all those platforms you want to conveniently play on. And I've started to build. Also, we've been developing a new server for a few months now, and I've been working on a separate version of the client for that, so I had to manage two code bases, which was a lot of trouble. And this week I started to merge the old client and the new client into a new one, and also do the first steps of turning Coregrounds from one page of a website into a whole full-fledged app. And there's a lot of planning going on and architecture stuff, which may sound or seem boring, but actually I think it's very exciting to have something that was procedurally built over 1.5 years put into order and do it right. It's actually a lot of fun
planning. See how you actually spectate the game as well?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's cool. It's really cool. So it's only the fifth game or something?
Yeah.
And the players using the abilities and the minions and the tower quite well already.
Yeah.
I'm impressed. Good gameplay. Sorry, I was interrupting you.
No, it's fine. It's perfectly fine. I was done anyway. Perfect timing. And that game is good indeed. Funny picks, but it's really cool to see that he's. I'd say he's winning against a superior build. The repeater and those kind of minions. It's tough to win against that. It's even more of an accomplishment if you take the picks into account.
And now all the minions rush into the core.
Yay! Stomido!
Congratulations!
Nice. Well played, man.
Yeah, well fought. If he watches the broadcast later, he'll probably be embarrassed a little bit. But
nah, what at all. No, not at all. It's nice play. Nicely played. Oh. Oh, Gabriel is exploding minions madly.
Wow, the rockets are super strong. They just one-shot these minions.
Yep, she's upgraded them fully. She's upgraded everything. She's actually ahead of the AI in terms of upgrades. That is pretty cool. But she's not using her towers.
I wonder if...
Yeah, but the enemy can't do shit.
Now, build a wall. Bam! Minion limit! Cool.
Oh, and now look at the rockets. Oh, look at that. One rocket is killing a tank. Oh, they're strong.
That's crazy. I didn't know that's possible. I mean, I have level 9.
Against level 14, even.
Wow. I wonder if that should be possible.
Good question.
Thanks, Gabriel. You just opened a new balancing topic in my head.
But look at that. Already going to the core. Oh.
Whoa.
That could be game already. I mean, those lasers.
You saw that? That was 25% of the core.
Yeah. Just two rockets going in there. Half the core is gone.
Crazy.
Oh, he's gonna win it. That is game. Nice. We've seen two very cool wins in a row.
Congratulations to nice. Gabrielle.
Nicely played.
I'm especially proud of Gabrielle because she, or he, I'm not sure, lost a couple games in a row and finally came through and won a game.
It's especially nice to see. I mean, we've just talked about the onboarding and that it's sort of a problem right now. And knowing that, it's even cooler and it's even more awesome to see people succeed and like and conquer the game. It's cool.
Yeah. But so we already touched the topics. In my eyes, the four big topics are, as you just said, work on the client and have it to be an app. Sure. that's a Then the second thing is improve the onboarding, that includes a tutorial that is not on YouTube but in the game. Then the third thing is to improve the AI and have gameplay that is more fun for, especially for beginners, and more challenging for better players. And what is the fourth thing? Oh, the UI,
yeah.
The user interface. And we already planned a lot for the user interface, so you probably see that coming through quite soon.
Yeah, the thing is, we'll showcase parts of that beforehand. The thing is, this patch is gonna be a bigger one. We could do parts of it, especially updating the AI or something, would be relatively easily done. That could be done at once, but we rather want to do bigger patches, which, I don't know, instead of, It's hard to keep up with the game being up to, we've done that last year, updating the game basically every 2 weeks, and that was a bit too much to if you weren't active every single day, every single week, it was hard to keep up. So we decided we would rather do bigger patches, and this one is definitely gonna be a bigger patch. I'm thinking about 5 new units, all these the tutorial UI changes, all this kind of stuff is gonna take a while. At least 4 weeks, I'd say, before the patch hits the servers. But as we develop it, we'll definitely share progress, especially on something like the UI. You'll definitely see screenshots and GIFs and all that kind of stuff,
and you will probably see it in a dev stream.
Yeah, which we will be doing on a weekly basis from now on.
Yep.
Because last week on Games Week, it was so nice to speak with all these people and see them play the game and have their feedback coming in. I mean, we had a very awesome community all over the last year. But it was somewhat on a smaller basis. A lot of it was based on the Skype group, and it wasn't as open for new players. And I think a stream on a weekly basis definitely is going to change that. It's going to be a regular thing. People might have to see it one or two or three times before they jump in, but they'll see it and eventually get there and become a part of the discussion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. One cool thing to announce is that we actually have our own category on Twitch now.
Yay.
So
if you want to stream Coregrounds, go.
If you want to stream Coregrounds, you can actually select Coregrounds as a game now, which is quite cool. And yeah, we wonder if it's if it's harder to attract viewers that way, but
it probably is.
You will know, and we'll make you know that every Thursday from now on, if and we're able to make it,
we will be at least one of us.
Yeah, we'll stream Coregrounds, and you can hop in and let us know what you think. Yeah. Also, if you want to let us know what you think, it's funny that I used that sentence because it's on
it's
my screen.
It's exactly on the screen.
It's on my stream again as well. Yeah, found a bug. Just want to say hi. Please do head over to the feedback form and speak your mind. Yeah. So that's a way you can contact us as well. If you are not able to come here on Thursdays, you can just use the feedback form and leave us a message.
Yeah.
And we'll be happy to respond, even if there are thousands of messages, which will probably not happen as soon, but we'll answer every message.
Exactly. And we're very open to ideas. I mean, you've probably gathered that from the DevGrounds or stuff. But we respond to everything and we take everything into account. Even if we do some things differently, nothing goes unnoticed. We think about it all.
Yes. Sometimes we have suggestions where we think that they probably do not fit that well for the game, but I actually appreciate these comments or ideas as well, because it makes you think about the game more and makes you question if it's the right decision or not.
Yeah.
And
yeah, definitely.
It's always appreciated. Okay.
All
now,
right.
Is there anything to say about the next patch? We have discussed about some units. We also have discussed a little bit about the changes that we want to make to the game. Maybe we should discuss a little bit about balancing as well. I know there's a notepad. Are there any pressing issues with the balance?
There definitely are. Minions. I'd say minions.
You do not look happy on your stream. It's funny.
What I do?
You do not look happy when I ask this question. You're like, I don't want to talk about balancing.
No, it's
the
fine.
The game
it's...
is perfectly balanced.
No, it's not. It's
Let's
definitely
not. Talk
not.
About that.
No, it's no. The thing is, it's. But the cool thing is indeed that it's the balancing is not as urgent as it was. I don't know, 6 months ago. The game is actually, quite fairly playable at the moment. Of course, we have ideas in every single game we play, and we have other directions we want the game to go in, but. If you compare it to a match you would have played half a year ago, it's miles apart. Yeah, but as
sure.
the general direction, I think minions have been buffed and buffed and buffed, and there have been new minions have been added that are very strong. So I think overall minions have become a little too strong, maybe. As I don't know, lately we've been balancing the game in much smaller steps and being way more careful in what we do, and I think given that approach we should turn to minions and maybe just nerf general HP basically.
Yeah.
Of all minions. Just a tiny, tiny bit, but to give the game a slight direction.
Yeah. Yeah, I think the turning point for me was changing the regeneration modification. We already talked about it. Mm. And since then, towers are just a lot weaker.
Mm.
And with this change, minions just became stronger generally. And one thing we'll do for is look at the health, as you already mentioned, especially for tanks, because there are many game situations where you can just bring so many minions on the map, and it's so hard to farm them, even if you have towers that are made for farming minions. So for example, if you have the boom bladder that should be able to keep a minion line under control against maybe tanks, it's just impossible to get rid of the tanks. So also we thought about reducing spawn speed on certain minions. So you have to think about like when to spawn minions more. This would be a really slight change, but it would kind of bring the game into a state where you don't mindlessly spawn minions, and you actually have to think about when to spawn minions and kind of help your minions
with the towers.
Help the minions to stay alive.
Yeah.
Because right now you just sacrifice your minions all the time because you know, okay, I can spawn minions as much as I want. Also, we saw it in a game today, if you have ability like mass production, you can upgrade your towers, your minions, and spawn minions still. What I want to say is you can have a lot of on the map and upgrade them without thinking about it. I would like it more if you kind of have to think about it as well. And if you do an upgrade, it will cause more of a lag in your minion line. So yeah, one way to conquer that is to reduce spawn speed on some minions slightly, and on some minions morely.
Yeah, that is a very interesting topic, because we've been also thinking about the fact that it's a lot worse for towers if they die. If you send your minions into a huge cluster of enemy towers, they die, yeah, and the enemy gets XP, yeah. But still, you don't have a real hard disadvantage from your minions dying, and you can just spawn them and leave them be. It would be interesting to have a different kind of mechanic affecting that, like for example, if your minions kill stuff, they get a buff on spawn speed, and if they just mindlessly die, they get a little less spawn speed. Something like that might be an interesting mechanic that, yeah, we might implement one day or another.
We have to think about that.
Definitely, it's just I just wanted to mention that the idea was around.
Yeah. Funny thing, I think we have two people who. How do you say that? Addictively play this game right now.
Do you mean Gabriel and Slomito?
Yeah, they're playing against
again. They're going
again.
Nice.
Wow, I think Gabriel has a hard match to win here, and it will be hard to win this. But Slomito actually has.
Oh, why has she picked four minions and the heater?
It's interesting, right?
But on the other hand, I mean, her her minion setup is, look at that. I mean, she will be putting out so much damage now alone with this wave. Look at that.
Yeah. All right, but let's get back to the balancing. So we touched the topic of minions. Also, we already talked about some towers today. For example, the Boom Blaster is not working that now. Also, I think like the Executioner could get some more versatility, and we have to see how it works out with having more abilities supporting the Executioner.
Or more units, more stuff like the Freezer, for example.
Yeah. Let's see, I have to look in the list, actually. Then we have a huge problem with the Radiator, in my opinion, because... okay, Mario has to laugh. Actually, the Radiator works quite well right now, but the problem is that it has too much range in combination with education. So we have to kind of recalculate the range value, because with its range plus the range modification, it gets too strong in the late game. And probably I'll just suggest to change the range a little bit. So that will happen probably in the patch. So if you haven't tried the Radiator yet, and you want to play a game that gets into the late game,
yeah,
pick it and just have it destroy everything.
Yeah, the thing is,
you have to
upgrade it a bit, but you don't even need full upgrades on the range. I think, if I remember correctly, it's only 3 upgrades you need, and something about level, I don't know, 12 to 15 or something, and suddenly this one is damaging everything in more than a 2 tiles radius. So at once it's attacking, I don't know, 15 walls or something.
It's crazy.
It's crazy. It's really crazy. It can clean up a battlefield in a minute. And it's very hard to take care of.
Oh.
Since it's also moving fast, because it's dealing damage while it's moving, you can keep it moving all the time and just be annoying. Oh, look at that. Pushing for the core. And that is going to be a shitload of damage Gabriel is putting out now. That might be game. Look at that. And the Boom Blaster is not there to defend. That is a one game in 13 minutes. No, it's not. The shield saves it. Look at that. Ability timing from the AI. Oh, that is beautiful stuff.
Funny. And wow, that's almost a highlight.
It is.
The funny thing
is, it's not even... I mean, that's incredible. I mean, the AI is so boring from the code. The AI is boring. It's just checking where are my units on the map. Okay, I have a cluster of 5 units here. Let's put an ability there. But if you play it, it looks so... I don't know. It looks so reactive and cool.
It's funky, right?
Yeah. Oh, but look at that push. Oh, she's gonna win it. This push is gonna win the game.
Yeah. Again, here we see that minions alone can win a game against 4 towers. I mean, we have to admit the towers are not positioned perfectly, but still.
That was a bit of a waste of the minion line there, with the minion limit explosions.
Yeah. But maybe it's a mechanic...
Oh!
The player has to learn first.
Yeah.
Alright, so back to the topic. I mean, we love, as you see, we love to spectate games and see
talk
what the,
about it.
See what the players do and kind of reflect on, especially when they're new players, it's really interesting for us to see how they play the game.
Definitely.
And I'm still surprised by the UI AI. It's crazy. That was perfect.
That was a highlight. For the next gameplay highlight video, that's definitely going to be in there.
Okay. Then, I think... yeah, we have to see. In my opinion, the units, like a unit like shotgun, could get a buff as well. But if we nerf the minions, we have to kind of test it out first.
Yeah.
It actually could be at a good point if the minions have less health. So we have to see that. But in my opinion, the shotgun is a little bit too weak at the moment, especially against minions. Yeah, just a little bit though. It's a slight change again.
Yep.
And might be good once we change the minions.
It's quite interesting to see now though. Right now we're not nearly at the amount of units we want to have in the game one day, but already it's so complicated. You change one thing here and it secretly affects 1,000 other things you didn't have in mind beforehand. It's funny. And it's gonna get more complicated like that. So the balancing itself, it's gonna be ever trickier.
Alright, then abilities. I think the abilities are at a good point right now. Mass production maybe could use a nerf. I'm not sure.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so. Maybe a longer cooldown because it's still so strong.
Yeah. No, I mean
we've seen the game. Was that our game? Yeah, we played where I had the mass production, right?
Yeah. I'm not sure though. We have to see. Again, the mass production gets weaker once we nerf the minions. So you have to be careful with that. Other than that, I think maybe adrenaline could use a shorter duration.
Yeah, it's very long. I think so.
It actually has a duration of 10 seconds at the moment.
Yeah.
Maybe something
7
like...
would be enough.
Yeah, we have to test it. My first thought was like 8.5 seconds or something like that. But...
No, I think so. It's something I ban often because I think it's overpowered.
Yeah.
Definitely.
And other than, I think the abilities are fine. I mean, explode, it will not change now. It will change later.
Yeah. But it will change, yeah.
It will change.
That. Will that be the game-winning push? No, the thing is, look at that. Gabriel is actually taking the time. He or she is actually enjoying it very much to kill those towers. Look at that. She can't stop. She won't stop. Kill them all.
I don't know if she's doing that, like, on purpose.
I think so. I mean, those were pretty nicely targeted on the boom blaster before.
Let's see if the rockets one-shot the tanks again. Nope.
They are fully upgraded though. But this time the tanks are too. If you look at that.
The thing is that they exploded before they hit the tank, and that's one game mechanic we introduced when changing the minion limit, that the rockets actually deal damage if they hit the target. So if you use your rocket and have it explode with the minion limit mechanic, then the rockets will not deal as much damage. But if the rockets actually hit their target, I think they deal 3 times the damage. So
I don't think it's that much. I think it's a lower modifier, something like 1.5.
150%.
Yeah.
So almost 3 times.
Look at
but,
that. He's getting all these towers. That was the second tower kill. with the minion limit within a few seconds, and that is, I don't know, the fifth game or so he or she's playing. That is amazing stuff. I think we can be proud of those players. And look at that, now the minion line is going in there directly. They have to move, they have to move. Yay! Come on, kill those! And it's gone. Oh man, I love it. It's so awesome to watch this game.
Unfortunately, the minions are not running. They got stuck on the tanks.
Yeah.
Otherwise, they would change direction.
Yeah. Exactly.
At some point. Oh, that's perfect! They just pass each other. Okay, I see it delayed. I have to spectate it as well.
I see it on my screen.
Oh, there's another player plane.
Why are you exploding them? No! They have to reach the core for you to do damage. Wait, what? We have another one? That's crazy.
Yep.
But my internet connection, I don't know what's up today, but today it's weird. It's so slow. Anyway, I think it's pretty late. And
yep.
I think I'm gonna have to go to bed soon. But as we're doing that regularly now, I don't think it's much of a problem.
Yep. Well, conclude. We played a couple games today. We saw that I'm not a good player. Then we talked a little bit about this week. We actually really enjoyed the games week last week in Berlin. And then we talked about some things that we want to introduce to the game, including... I have to quit the spectator. I cannot think if I hear that. Including changes to the UI and the onboarding for players, changes to the AI, so many abbreviations.
Yeah.
And also, as like a far goal ahead, that we're going to introduce a new client and a new server as well, but not for the next patch. Then we also talked a little bit about balancing what we think about the current meta and how we would like to change it. And now we're here. At the end of the first weekly dev stream.
Exactly. And I would like to add one thing. As we're doing this on a weekly basis now, in case you have any ideas what you want to do, if you have an idea for the dev stream, go ahead, give us a shout, tell us. I think would be some nice little show matches, even with a prize tag on them. For example, a best of three, a best of five between two players, winner gets 5,000 coins, something like that. Anything. If you have any ideas, just tell us about them and we'll definitely see if we can get this going, whatever it is.
Yeah, I would like that. So, if you're interested to play show match, let us know and we'll try to set it up, or we'll try to find an opponent for you.
Sure, yeah, good idea.
Also, if you're watching on YouTube, then how do you say it in English? Subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Twitch channel, or...
I'm getting to that.
Sorry, yeah.
First, if you're watching on YouTube, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. You'll see the weekly dev stream, hopefully.
Yep.
If that's technically possible.
Yep.
And you can write comments if you like, also on YouTube. Also, we have the tutorial here on YouTube. You can watch the tutorial and get better at the game. And what we'll do in the future is also kind of post videos on gameplay and post videos on units, so you can stay informed about everything and learn to be better at the game. All right, then, if you're on Twitch right now, what I do not think, you can leave a follow on Twitch.
Here, hit the button, down here.
Down here. No, you can just head to our Twitch account, which is twitch.tv/coregrounds, and you can hit follow and you will be informed when we go live. So, as we said, we're going to be live every Thursday night now for the dev stream, but maybe we'll be live in between and stream when we play. We'll see. Then also, we have social media, of course. You can go over to Twitter and tweet us. And also, you can see the tweets on the front page. So you might get a nice mention in our tweet stream. How do you call that? The tweet lifeline?
Yeah.
See, I'm not a Twitter guy, so
activity stream timeline. I think they call it timeline.
Timeline, isn't that a Twitter, Facebook thing?
Twitter timeline. Yeah, maybe I'm confusing them. Yeah.
Yeah, but as you see, it's on the front page. If you're logged in, you can see tweets, and maybe you can start a conversation there as well. And then also we have Facebook. Facebook is a nice way to stay informed as well. We're trying our best. But for now, if you like our videos, then I think YouTube and Twitch would be the most important. All right.
And of course, play the game.
Yes.
Play it, get good at it, beat all your friends, and become a champion of the Coregrounds.
Especially beat us.
Yep.
The thing is,
that's something we could do too. Beat the devs.
Beat the devs. I'm not as good as the game right now, so it's a good chance to beat me, or there is a good chance to beat me, but if you want to be a real pro, then you have to beat Mario. No, I'm kidding.
We have a reigning champion on the Coregrounds, Hanjul. If you want to really lose at a Coregrounds match, go play him.
No, you can get better than him, I think. All right, so I also will wish you the best on the Coregrounds. Have fun. And if you're not having fun, let us know.
Yep.
And I think that's it for today.
That's it for today. See you next Thursday at 9 p.m. CET.
CET, Central
European Time.
Time, yeah. Okay, cool.
Thanks for being with us. It was fun. And see you next week, guys.
Bye-bye.